Hey, this is Sebastian for the Metal Gods Meltdown, and I'm joined by
Daniel Mir from Civil War.
It's awesome to be speaking to you tonight. The last full measure has been out a while now. What's the general response been like from both media and the fans?
Well, it's been really positive, actually, that we were a little bit nervous in the beginning, you're always nervous before a new release and everything, that the people wouldn't like it, because we have taken a slightly different direction, but not too much on the album, and see what the people thought about it. But it has in general been very, very positive, that from the media, the response have been way over our expectations, and the fans also seem to love it. So we are very satisfied and happy with the result. And yeah, that's all I have to say, really, that we're being surprised.
It is awesome. Could you tell me your favorite track today from the last measure?
Yeah, well, my favorite track always is Tombstone. That was like the only song that when I heard the first excerpt of the finished demo, I was like, oh shit, this is gonna be so great. So, it was like so far out, so different from what we usually do and what metal bands in general do. It was like a totally different approach on something. That there are not too many bands that use this ska, reggae, country in metal. I only heard it a couple of times and for like short periods of a song, but not to this extent.
I know, the first time I heard it, I was like, what the fuck? And then like, yeah. It's amazing. It's so addictive and different.
Dark holiday, had a very lousy day. Coughed real bad, said someone has to pay. Big nose kid prayed for dark holiday. Old Kick O'Rell, they were there to give them hell. The three brothers surfed, this could never end up well. Legends foretell about old Kick O'Rell. So God is paid, here in Tombstone again. There were rifles and guns, there were cowboys for fun. These were tough boys to break, three more tough fish to mate. No one cared, no one cared. Who will die, who will live, who will piss on your grave? No one cared, no one cared. Yes, your lord, yes, your order, this is man's land.
Right, sheriff, right, many outlaws have to die. Seek and destroy, let the lonely widows cry. It's landed a time, so right, sheriff, right. Dark holiday, he had a very lousy day. He followed his friends, it's the brotherhood of men. Big nose kid cried for dark holiday.
A showdown in flames here in Tombstone again. There were rifles and guns, there were cowboys for fun. A showdown in flames here in Tombstone, my friend. These were tough boys to play, three more conflicts to make. No one cared, no one cared. Who will die, who will live, who will piss on your brain?
We're tough boys to break, three more conflicts.
if I was a Civil War virgin, which two tracks from the band's three albums would you choose to introduce me to the band?
Let's see now. Then we should probably go, well, the two classics, I Will Rule the Universe and Rome is Falling. Those two are definitely on the list. Then I would probably try some fast song also, because those are quite mid-tempo. And I have no clue, actually. But I guess something like maybe Gods and Generals. Probably Bay of Pigs. That one is, well, it's also mid-tempo, but it's one of the songs that people seem to have a, like, say, easy approach to. It's a good song for first-time listening.
I know this is the end of this part of the trilogy regarding the album titles. What's next for Civil War?
I'd tell you if I knew. We have actually no clue what it's going to be in the future. But of course, I guess we will stay on the historical subject, but maybe move away a little bit from the American Civil War, because, well, there is... Well, there is a shitload to write about it, but I think we don't want to water it out. So maybe try some more like actual historical events, maybe not only war and stuff like that. Because, well, Sabaton is covering that already, and we don't want to paint ourselves too much into a corner when it comes to the subject. So we're going to try to, like, spread it out a little bit.
Have you thought about going down the Viking road, being Vikings?
Nah. I think that that area is also quite watered out. I mean, there are so many Viking bands, and I mean, we already have one song about Vikings anyway. So
yeah,
Tears from the North, the Guns N' General album, so Big Furs and stuff like that. Actually, so I guess we will see what will happen stage-wise and stuff like that, because, well, those coats, especially the ones that me and Patrick are wearing, they are quite damn warm, because it's like thick wool.
Yeah.
And they can get really horrible sometimes.
I can imagine. You are a party metal band, without a doubt, bringing history back to life and kicking ass with some metal mayhem, my favourite sort of subject. But the whole way the world seems to be heading in at the moment with the Middle East, the refugee crisis, Trump, etc. Are the band tempted to write about the current political climate, or are you wanting to just stay far away from that?
It's really tricky when you're trying to touch recent or ongoing events. Because there are so many twists and turns, and you actually don't know that much about it. So you only don't know that there is conflicts going on around there. You don't really know what it is about and everything. So to write about current events, that's something that we would never do. Well, it is sensitive.
It is.
And we don't want to get involved politically or anything like that, because that's a risk when you start writing about things like that, that you get into the political corner and then you might get stuck totally, because you write something that someone dislikes and then you're more or less screwed.
So going back to the themes that Civil War deal with, how important is it to you personally to keep these historic stories alive?
Well, of course, it's always important to remember history, because, well, past events is what formed our current situation. So even if it's happened like 400 years back, it has formed us some way. Of course, we want to keep history alive for that.
Mm-hmm.
And through music, that's quite good ways that you can keep it like more a laid back approach to it, and not being like a history book when you read facts up and down. you can enjoy a little bit. I mean, it's really hard to cover a full historical event in one song unless you write like 25-minute prog hits.
I hope that you're going to sort of get the next chapter of Civil War together pretty soon. Do you think there's going to be a possibility of an album in 2017?
Well, I don't think we will be that fast this time. I mean, people think that the time between Guns N' Generals and the Last Full Measure was so short. It was just because Guns N' Generals was finished almost a year before it was released. So, well, you never know if we get into this creative mood, and then there might be an album very shortly, but I don't think the label will try to overwork us. But on the other hand, we work quite well under pressure. It's so great now that the songwriting doesn't only fall on me and Patrick, that now we also have Petrus with us. That is one hell of a riff maker and is really good at writing songs. That he's been doing a lot of work on the Last Full Measure. I mean, he was already helping us out a little bit on the Killer Angels. I think if we would be put under pressure, you might have a new album quite soon, but I'm not sure how the quality would be like. We're gonna try to take it a little bit easy and not hesitate just to get the new album out, because this one was received so well and we want to ride on this wave. It's better to sit back and relax a little bit and let it sink in before you start writing new stuff. But as I can say, I think we already have a couple of small ideas lying around, so we have already started a little.
And wait for the new horizon. We are an army without uniforms. Now we're bonded by blood, signed and sealed, a pact that we live forever. The final ordeal has arrived. Baby, it's coming down. My heaven can't wait, 'cause we have so many more battles to win.
Oh,
been out on tour, haven't you, recently? What does the rest of 2016 hold in store for you guys? Have you got festivals lined up for 2017 already?
The rest of this year is quite calm, actually. We only have one gig down in Israel, in Tel Aviv, in the middle of December. Yeah, nice and warm. Really looking forward to that. I mean, it's been, 6 years since I was there last time, and there have some friends down there that I haven't seen since then, so it's going to be great to meet them. And so I'm really looking forward to that one. Yeah, well, we have booked a couple of festivals. I don't remember which ones now, but we are still looking for more of them.
Right.
And as it looks now, somewhere during March, April, there's going to be a headliner / co-headliner tour. So we have some offers that we are dealing with. And now we just have to check up with the routing and all the planning around booking venues and stuff like that.
If you could be one person from history, who would it be and why?
Whoa, that's a tricky one. Well, if I was a person from history, I don't know exactly. And if I would be like someone really famous or something, what would it? I don't think I would actually change some or anything like that. Some normal person and get to see something from close by, so to say. I would like to be a bystander, but then I have to choose what.
Sorry.
Well, it would be interesting to see how the French Revolution went, actually. So how, like, the whole atmosphere and stuff like that. Choose that one because I used to play with I still play the Assassin's Creed games, and there is one about the French Revolution there, so that one really caught me with its storyline. So it would be cool to actually see that part.
Do you actually manage to keep up with the new metal releases? And what was the last album you listened to?
Oh, new metal releases. As I really don't listen that much to new music anymore. I mean, I'm so occupied with my own stuff, I know my girlfriend is a music reporter also, so she listens to shitloads of stuff, the new stuff all the time, so I always get lost with what I see now. So one album that has been rolling quite a lot at home is the new Dynasty album. So she's a little bit more into that stuff, and also a lot of progressive. The new Dynasty album, that one is probably the one I put most notice to lately.
Right.
Since, she plays it all the time. Sometimes you run into something new, but for me, nowadays, it's mostly not non-metal stuff. It's more like progressive rock. It's 70s weird stuff, and actually quite a lot of classical music lately. I try to explore that part a little bit more. Run into some really weird stuff there, every here and there.
Does the Sabaton question totally bore the band now? It does me. You guys are so much more than Sabaton ever are or were, in my humble opinion.
We're kind of used to it. It's like an ordinary day at work that you get to answer those questions, of course. But it seems like people in general don't ask that much about it anymore because, they've heard everything.
That's good to hear.
They heard our answers like 100 times now, so they don't ask them that much. They always try to concentrate more on Civil War than on the Sabaton business. Quite nice, actually.
That's positive. That's a positive thing to hear as well, because you're a band in your own right, aren't you? How would you describe the mood of the band right now?
Laid back. We have been enjoying those, 2 weeks, or was it last week that we released the album?
God, when was it? It was last week, wasn't it? Yeah, I think.
Yeah, it was last week.
I'll put my review up.
A little bit laid back, looking at the reactions. We had one rehearsal that totally failed because I forgot the backing tracks and everything, so we didn't do anything. But we have started rehearsing. We're going to play the new songs and also get in shape for the gig in Israel so we don't come there and have forgotten half of the songs.
It's the 4th of November it was released, actually, but weeks have flown. It's the 23rd now, so it's nearly 3 weeks already. It's crazy. Yeah.
3 weeks.
Yeah, 3 weeks, man. It's just,
what the hell?
I know. I can't believe that either. I can't believe that.
It feels like it was like 1 week ago. It sounded like, it's 1 week ago. Yeah, 3 weeks.
It is 3 weeks, yeah. I'm pretty shocked too. It's like, where's the time gone? Okay, I've got like quick fire questions. They're just like for fun, so you know. Festival or small intimate gig?
Small gigs.
Vinyl or CD?
Vinyl.
Viking or Clansman?
Well, I'm a Viking, so I go for that.
ABBA? Or a head, or your head in a bucket of ice cold water.
Head in a bucket of ice cold water.
Lapland, or I know this is a Finnish question actually, but anyway, Lapland or Lapdancer land.
Well, actually, my roots come from the northern of Sweden, around Lapland, so I say that. Well, I hope you all guys really enjoy the new album as much as we do, and other people seem to do. And I hope to see you somewhere on the road in the future, or on the festival. So, we might even grab a beer. I'm not the one that's shy on that. Hello, this is Daniel Mir from Civil War, and you're listening to Metal Gods Meltdown.
Dark holiday, had a very lousy day. Coughed real bad, said someone has to pay. Big nose kid prayed for Dark Holiday. Old King Corral, they were there to give them hell. The three brothers served, this could never end up well. Legends foretell about Old King Corral. A showdown in fans here in Tombstone again. There were rifles and guns, there were cowboys for fun. Showdown in fans here in Tombstone, my friend. These were tough boys to break, three more coffins to make. No one cared, no one cared. Who may die, who may leave, who will piss on your grave. No one cared, no one cared. Yes, you know.
Right, many outlaws have to die. Seek and destroy, let the lonely widows cry. It's the end of the time, so ride, Sheriff, ride.
Yep, yep, yep.
Dark Holiday had a very lousy day. He followed his friends, it's the brotherhood of men. Big Nose Kid cried for Dark Holiday.
A showdown in flames here in Tombstone again. There were rifles and guns, there were cowboys for fun. Showdown in flames here in Tombstone, my friend. These were tough boys to break, three more conflicts to make. No one cared, no one cared. Who will die, who will live, who will piss on your grave. No one cared, no one cared. There's no law, there's no order, this is man's land. Die, die, say goodbye.
I'm gonna leave you for a while, honey. I'm gonna spend some time with you.
We're tough boys to break.